What's up guys, my name is Arina and welcome to my channel where I review everything tech. So, it's been about 2 months since I started using my OnePlus 7 Pro as my semi-daily driver, and right away let's talk about the price of this phone. It cost me $700 before tax for 8GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. Let's make a quick throwback to that unboxing moment and see what you get in the box. With the OnePlus 7 Pro you get a case, a Warp Charge 30 power adapter, a Warp Type-C cable, some paperwork, SIM tray ejector, and stickers. I got my OnePlus 7 Pro in a Nebula blue color. You could also get it in mirror gray and almond. But I'm totally in love with this blue color, and to be honest, when I saw a picture of the OnePlus 7 Pro in Nebula blue for the first time, I thought it would look cheap, but in fact it looks expensive and beautiful, especially when the phone is slowly moving and the color appears to be changing at different angles. Good job, OnePlus! Just like its predecessor, the 6T, the OnePlus 7 Pro has a glass finish encased by a metal frame. I would say it's pretty average in terms of weight, not too light but not too heavy. And when it comes to the size of this phone, I would definitely put it into plus slash max category. It's slightly taller and a little bit slimmer when compared to the iPhone XS Max, and it's pretty much the same as the Pixel 3 XL in terms of size. When it comes to design of this phone, once again we can see the dedicated sound slider on the side of the OnePlus 7 Pro that lets you easily put your phone on vibrate or completely silence the phone. I've always been a huge fan of this little detail because it's so convenient and you don't have to fiddle with the notification panel. Now let's talk about the display of this phone. The 7 Pro has an almost 6.7 inch AMOLED display with curved edges, it has tiny bezels and no notch. And guys, I remember when I just turned on my OnePlus 7 Pro for the first time, I was just staring at the display and couldn't look away because I literally felt hypnotized, especially with that default life wallpaper. This display is simply amazing, it's a game changer when it comes to the smartphone viewing experience, and yes, this is the first AMOLED display with a 90Hz refresh rate, it's battery smooth and all the swipes feel instant. The display is pretty bright, I usually keep the brightness at about 50-60% indoors and it feels more than enough for me. It doesn't look dim, but it still feels comfortable for my eyes. And let's do a quick test, I'll put the iPhone XS Max and the Pixel 3 XL side by side and see how these three phones compare when it comes to brightness. I hope the camera will be able to pick up all the differences. Let's start with 50%. And at that point, as you can see, the OnePlus 7 Pro appears to be the brightest. Next, let's make it 100%. And the iPhone XS Max is the winner here. So, maybe the OnePlus 7 Pro doesn't have the brightest screen I've ever seen, but I personally rarely keep the brightness at full throttle on any device, so this is not a problem for me, but keep it in mind if max brightness is important for you. Moving on to the biometrics and security features of this phone, and of course, let's start with the face unlock. It feels a bit different on the OnePlus 7 Pro when compared to its predecessor. Now the whole process is implemented by the pop-up front-facing camera. It actually feels futuristic, I love it, but with the OnePlus 7 Pro the face unlock takes a little longer due to the fact that it takes some time for the camera to pop up. I'm not a fan of selfies, so I don't use front-facing camera for taking photos too often, but taking into account how many times I have to unlock my phone with my face during the day, I have this slight fear that one day my pop-up camera will break. But so far so good, I guess time will tell. When it comes to the fingerprint scanner, it looks just the same as the one on the OnePlus 6T, but now it definitely feels faster. Also, you get a new fingerprint animation effect, which is called Ripple, or you could just turn the animation off, and since the fingerprint scanner got faster, you don't actually have time to properly see any of these effects anyway. Moving on to the battery life, and we get 4000 mAh on the OnePlus 7 Pro, that's a big one. It usually takes about 1 hour and 20 minutes to charge the battery from 0% to 100, and I think this is actually the fastest charging speed I've seen on any phone so far. And this is how the charging process usually looks on the line graph by minutes. The OnePlus 7 Pro easily lasts me through the day, but usually that's about it. Mind you, I always keep the refresh rate at 90Hz and your results could be better if you keep it at 60, so more likely than not, you will have to charge your phone every day. At times, this phone will last me one full day and it'll still have some juice left the next morning, but at the end of the day, of course, it will all depend on how hard you use your device. Just like the OnePlus 6T, the 7 Pro doesn't support wireless charging, and speaking of the limitations, it also doesn't have a headphone jack and IP68 rating, but if you already watched my previous video, I don't think you should worry about it. Next, let's talk about the speakers, and we can see a big improvement in this field. This time, we got stereo speakers on the OnePlus 7 Pro. They're very loud, the sound quality is amazing, especially if you watch movies, you will clearly notice that stereo effect. The OnePlus 7 Pro is powered by the Snapdragon 855. This phone is very snappy and the whole user experience has been very pleasant so far, except for my first 2 days with this phone. When I just got my OnePlus 7 Pro, there were some problems with the ambient display. The tap to wake on the screen didn't work, the double tap did not work, and the pick up to wake feature did not work either. Also, there was a problem with screen off gestures, and I was not the only one who was experiencing some of these malfunctions. And perhaps the most infuriating part about it all was that all of these features I just mentioned would work perfectly fine one moment and then would stop working for no reason. It just drove me crazy. However, big credit to OnePlus, they quickly fixed it and since then everything seems to be working just fine on my unit. When it comes to the camera on the OnePlus 7 Pro, I already have a very comprehensive camera comparison video on my channel, but as always, the OnePlus is constantly listening to their customers and always works on improvements, so I'm gonna do an updated video on the OnePlus 7 Pro's camera in the future, so stay tuned for that. So, this has been my experience and thoughts on using the OnePlus 7 Pro so far. I think that this is an amazing and very innovative smartphone, especially considering its very attractive price point. Let me know what you guys think about this phone. Thank you so much for watching this video and see you in the next one.